Hello and welcome to some more Train Simulator 2020 content, where today we're going to be taking first ScotRail 90021 between Carlisle and Glasgow Central with the London Euston to Edinburgh / Glasgow Lowland Sleeper. Rather looking forward to giving this a go. Hopefully it goes a tad smoother than my last excursion. Mind you, that was all down to what the AI were choosing to do. But if you would like to help support the channel, you can do by donating to the PayPal link found down below. Any and all funds go immediately back into the channel to help better the content only from this but other projects I have in the pipeline. Additionally, if you have any route recommendations or trains you would like to see me drive, please do let me know and I will see what I can do for you. Okay, so here we are. Let's just make sure we haven't got to do anything else. Nope. All right, hello, driver. As soon as you're ready, you may get on your way northwards to Glasgow Central. Get in there at 1718. Stopping at Carstairs, Motherwell on the way. Due to these stops being set down only, you may get the right away earlier than the booked departure time. Also, please note that Carstairs, you will need to detach the rear 8 coaches, which will continue to Edinburgh under control of another locomotive. Additionally, there is a 60 mile per hour temporary speed restriction in force at Ecclesfengumbugabugabuga that you must be aware of. Finally, your maximum permitted speed is 80 miles per hour, so as to provide a comfortable journey for those sleeping on board. Marvellous. Right, so, what I want to be here. What I do want to do is just go. Do that. There we go. Right, that's in. Marker lights. Let's just hop in here. That to dim. That to bright. Marker lights, tail lights. Fine, fine and dandy. Parking brake is off. That, I'm going to want to just turn that off. Right. Yes, thank you. Then I'm just going to want to ensure that I turn this off, although I might be in a bit of bother. Right, fine. No one's worried about me going ding dong, bleeding ding dong. Right, so hop to the back. Jolly good. We're hanging right off the edge in a rather scruffy looking Mark II. Let's hop to the front. Let's hop there, shall we? Turn that off. Let's just get that released. And we shall head out on our merry little quest. So you can get a representation of how the rolling stock looks. It's a lengthy old contest, isn't it? Oh, hello. What have we got here, then? We shall sit at the back and we shall see who this is. It is an EWS 66. I'm not going to bother accelerating to 60, since we've got the 25 limit coming up anyway. That's a Freightliner 66. With a decent ballast train. Suppose. Like that one. That's a bit of a jolt. Those passengers asleep are going to be in for a bit of a rude awakening, aren't they? Well, we've got 72 miles to go before our first scheduled stop at Carstairs, to which we'll be losing the rear 8 carriages. Yeah, well, seeing as we've got a bit of weight behind us, I think we can start accelerating quite happily. And we've got 80 limits, so we'll stick our speedometer or speed cruise control to 80. And we'll basically go from there. So we're due in just over an hour. Let's actually say what time we're doing in Carstairs. 6:19, leaving at 6:35. Blimey. Yeah, we've got a bit of a wait. It's not a bad sight. Actually handy having the DSD turned off, so I can actually enjoy myself without having to worry about having to nip into the cab every minute and a half. In fact, if I have my headlights set to night time running. There we are. That makes a whole heap of difference. I don't suppose I'm going to go inside. Oh, I can. Might want to close the window because that's quite loud. So according to this, we've got just over an hour to go. I don't know how much talking I'll be doing during this scenario. It all depends as to what we see. So for the most part, it'll be just enjoying what we could be seeing around. Any guesses on what the next locomotive was going to be that's going to take the rear eight cars on? It'll be interesting to see what trains we pass. Welcome to Scotland. Safe to say that these speed limits aren't going to really have much of an effect on me at all. This must be one of the summer months, seeing as it's 22 past 5 and it's quite light already. Mind you, in saying that, if this is the year 2013, then the trains that we should be seeing along here won't be intercity. Well, they shouldn't be anyway. I'm not going to complain if they are, but they shouldn't be intercity. It feels really slow at 79 miles an hour, but that is our permitted speed. We must not exceed it, otherwise we risk giving the passengers a sense of uncomfortability. So we have 60 miles of very easy running to do. I could just manually do it, of course. That totally didn't slip my mind. We dropped to 78. Oh dear. Whatever shall we do? Oh, 125 limit coming up. Well, we can do 125, but, you know, still, it's rather pretty. That's where I want to be. So it's going to be what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, I don't know, it's going to be... Hopefully we get enough. We've got enough Mark 3s left over, because there seems to be quite a few Mark 2s that sort of live towards the tail end of things. Actually getting quite light now, so I suppose I can probably change this to daytime running at some point. But we'll do that now. Yeah. Simple flick of the switch. We'll ignore the moon. To be fair, many people do. Many people ignore the moon. That's pretty cool. Get the sun glaring on the Mark III's and the real sort of battered body shell of the 90. Oh, hello. Pendolino. There we are. We've slowed down way sooner than I wanted to, but there we go. I did have how the neutral sections don't apply in this. So, why is it 60 along here then? I'm curious. I suspect we can probably find a spot to go and sit, I suspect. Nope, up here. Oh, of course, that was a temporary speed limit, wasn't it? Yep. You madman. You completely forgot what you were supposed to be slowing down for. Yes, I did.
You won't be tackled again, will you?
No, can't promise anything. Still got 52 miles to go. Interesting to see what else we get. So we've had a Freightliner 66, but a Virgin Trains Class 390 Pendolino. May even get some Voyagers come down. Cows. Nope. There we go. Out of all the liveries I've ever seen on a Class 90, the ScotRail Barbie livery is just brilliant. I remember when it was used to be 90s on the Caledonian Sleeper. And 90021 would make the odd appearance. But predominantly it was always Freightliner. We're heading through Lockerbie next. There's a station, so what we're going to do, we're going to hop out and we're just going to go ba-ba-da-ba-ba-da, all the way up. Oh, it's very dark here, isn't it? I love the difference in sound. I really do. At least it's nice and quiet inside the cab, but if you hop outside, different kettle of fish. It's really loud inside that Mark II. So it looks like we're due in early. What time are we due in still? 6:19, we're due in at 6:17. So yeah, we're doing well. So yeah, 10:508 is what I need to get rid of. Wait, Hold on. Whoa, wait a minute. Seriously, wait. Why not do it in number order? I don't get that. Okay. Oh. Anyway, that's what I'm doing. Okay, so we've got 38 miles to go. At least until we come to a stop in the down loop. So I don't know. If we could be making way for another train behind us. Nope, there's nobody ahead of us so far, so we've just had the one Pendolino pass us. Neutral section coming up, which doesn't affect us, weirdly. The thing is, we're only going fractionally faster than the permitted line speed of a freight train. I'm sure a freight train can only do about 75 miles an hour. And so far, it's been exceptionally smooth sailing. Mind you, given the time of the day, I don't expect to see many trains along here. Let's see what happens the closer we get to Glasgow. Speaking of which, 66, DRS on a very light container train. Decent length, but very light. Well, a nice climb ahead of us, so it'll be interesting to see what speed we do lose. In fact, what I might do, I don't know if by upping that in any way, shape, or form may end up helping us in any way. It probably doesn't, but it's there anyhow. Pulled over for his all-nighter. See how much speed we do end up losing. Yeah, the sun hasn't risen too much, seeing as that's not really making much of a difference. I mean, it's not like we're losing speed at an alarming amount, but it's definitely not ideal that we've lost 11 miles an hour. It's still dropping. I don't know if that's going to make any difference. It might just give us a little bit more traction and just keep us going. Answer is not really. Okay, well, I'll do that then. Mind you, going uphill is a fair amount of weight for one loco to pull. The sooner we get to the summit, the better. Come on, girl, you can do it. I have the utmost faith in your abilities, more so than my own. It looks like we're going to be leveling out. Give us a chance to claw back some speed. Through the cutting. Leveling out and then going partially downhill. Yep, got the train just auto brake itself. I am going to try at something. I'm going to try one of these, like a long distance zoomed in type of a shot, and see what we can come up with. Actually came out better than I thought. Okay, so we've got 20 miles to go before we come to a halt. We then presumably get then the clearance to move into Carstairs Platform 2 to detach the rear 8 carriages, where we'll then be waiting, and then head off to Motherwell and then Glasgow Central. Next scenario after this will be taking a Virgin Trains livery class 90 with a dead intercity 90 with a Mark 3 set of mixed colour from Carlisle to Glasgow Central. After that, we will be taking a HSC from Carstairs to Glasgow Central. May do a couple of bits of freight, and then we'll nip into the East Coast Mainline Peterborough to York section. Not a bad view from the office today. Again, all these speed limits, they do not affect me in the slightest. Okay, just over 16 miles to go. Ignore the fact that the catenary has not loaded in completely, it's fine. And even when it has loaded, it's sort of just doing its own thing. makes sense to them. Doesn't necessarily have to make sense to me, but then again, nothing really does. I wonder. I'm going to try something else. Have I got enough time? Spin around. Cheeky zoom. I love it. Absolutely love it. I'm sure the passengers on board are enjoying their slumber. If they would look out the certain carriages, they could see a passing through some of the most gorgeous scenery in northern England. Okay, just over under 12 miles to go. Looks like we're going to be due in nice and early. Well, into the loop, that is, anyway. He should have a spotter with him instead of just standing there. It's quite dangerous. Okay, 10 miles to go, so we're slowly rattling down the numbers. Do sheep to be seen? No end of agricultural farmland? Miles to go, then we can rest the 90 for a brief period. The 390. And we're getting gradually ever closer to Carstairs. Oh, we've got here then. Okay. Well, I wasn't expecting the first Great Western 166 to be coming down, but there we are. We'll just say that at first ScotRail had a few of them on lease and have sent them back down to Great Western. We'll go with that. It's probably one of the more believable I can come up with. It's about the only one I can come up with. No cows. Okay, 3.5 miles to go. So I'm expecting to see the signal starting to change in due course. Okay, and there's the signal that's going to be telling us we're going to be coming up to a crossover. We'll see. Well, we have to stop at Carstairs down loop exit 3 is where I need the loco. Okay, you must now detach through 8 coaches, which will continue to Edinburgh under control of another locomotive. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good job, now load and unload passengers and await the right of way. So ideally, I just find that amazing, yeah. We'll unload and unload passengers from, these carriages. I suppose that is where we've parted ways. I am pretty convinced that that rolling stock is going backwards. It's creeping. That's going to be a problem. Yeah, that's going to be a real issue. There's no way I can't even select it. Okay, hopefully it stops. Where am I? Is it here? Is it stopped? Oh, it's creeping. That could be a problem. I should have put the handbrake on that rolling stock when I did this. That's going to be an issue, I feel. Is there another loco back here that's going to help? Don't think there is. Oh, there is. There's a loco there. DB Schenker 90018. Okay, so hopefully. Actually, okay, that's fine. So if the points are set, which they're not, that rolling stock should go back into that. I just hope it's not going to be too bad. Oh, hello. Hello, Voyager. Those are Virgin Trains 221 Super Voyager. That's still rolling back. Really, really slowly. I'm hoping that when it comes to it, we can just disappear. But I'm kind of surprising that we had to sit that far up. You know. Right, so does that now... Just curious when... You're going to turn up. Because I really don't... I can change those points. Ooh, I don't know. I'm quite nervous about that now. Oh, that's going to be... That could be quite problematic. Oh, I don't know. So what time are we actually due in here anyway? Oh, Christ, I can't see. There we go. Right, I was due in at 6:19 and leaving at 6:30. 6:35?! Duty has been set, you may get the right of way earlier than the book departure time. I hope so. Crikey. Okay, admit it, I got in here really early. Whenever you're ready, Chief, you know, just say the word, because your rolling stock is rolling. Hindsight, I should have put the handbrake on, but I didn't. I just find it strange I had to stop my train up here, but I mean, I guess it's to allow them up to sit in there, but then if you wanted to get off at Carstairs, you've then got to walk through the entirety of the train to get down here. Oh, I don't know. Makes sense to them. Too much I can do at this stage. I should just sit here and see if I can depart any earlier. It's slowing, which is nice, but that gap has got quite large. Oof. Oh, please, AI, just get a wriggle on. That's what I'm asking. Whoops, wrong way. Plenty of work going off from whatever that used to be. That is really high up as well. Must have been an old goods platform. I've never filmed at Carstairs. I don't think I've even watched any films from Carstairs, so I might have to come here one day. So, yeah, we're parked up there. Okay, that's fine. I'm generally surprised that we're not going to be making way for something else. Like another train just thundering around the outside of us, because we're going to be here for that length of time. So we're into a different Mark II this time. And it is... Oh, it's the last one. It is the last Mark II that we're going to be sat in for that one. Okay, cool. So presumably then, we were in that one last time around. Can I actually fiddle with that at all? It gave me the option to do so, I'm sure it did. I kind of want to on the off chance that I disappear and that keeps coming. Oh well, I'm sure they know what they're doing. Is it still moving? Really, really slowly, but still moving. Textures haven't loaded. Jolly good. Yes. I trust we will be able to leave much sooner than anticipated. Otherwise, you're sort of just sat here twiddling your thumbs. Panicking profusely about the
the rake that's currently behind me that's freewheeling. Surprised there's going to be nothing running around the outside of us after considering how long we're here for. Might be another freight train or something. More to the point, has that actually started to make a move yet? Nope, you're still sat there. Ooh, yes. Please. It's more concerning the fact that that's getting ever closer. And I cannot do anything, can I? No. Well, you know. Oh, that gap. Could ride a bus in between, though. Well, what will be. I'm sure they must have factored in a complete numbskull trying to drive this without applying the handbrake to the consist that I've just detached. I'm sure as hell hope they have. Just sit here and wait. There's literally nothing I can do. Absolutely nothing. I don't know. These excavators are working hard. And they may let us go hopefully 5 minutes early. So I'm just sat here watching the world go by. I really am concerned about that. So we're due to leave at 6:35. I don't know. So we're due in at 7:18 into
Glasgow.
Still got a while to wait yet, so, yeah. The beauty about this lot is that you lot watching this, you can just skip forward to when I start moving again. I've got to sit here and wait. Oh, hello. I hear something. Sure. I am on the belief then that that's a 166. Okay, yeah, just follow the couplings. Oh, okay. Oh, I love it. It even failed to load a train. Well, there's a thing. There it goes. So is it going around there, or is it going down there? I can't tell. Oh, God. Right, road driver, please note though that the signal ahead is currently having issues, so please press tab to attain permission to pass it at danger. No spiffing. Excellent. Okay, so next stop is Motherwell in 15 miles. Well, at least we got up to 80 miles, well, near enough 80 miles per hour quicker this time round. Interesting to see what other ghost trains we pass. And we're due into Motherwell on time. I imagine a lot of people will still be asleep. There may be a couple of people awake. Hello? 318? So we're starting to see a bit more variety in trains that we're seeing now. Look, there's an 80 limit coming up, and would you believe it, we're doing 80. So I think we'll be fine. We have a 70 coming up. Ooh-ah. And then a 60. Cool. They're spoiling us. But we're not too far away from Motherwell. slow us down sufficiently. That's exactly what we need it to do. Okay, we're 500 a bit miles away from Motherwell. So a real think with the speed there, isn't it? It's like, do I, don't I, do I, don't I, do I, don't I, do I, don't I? Okay, 4 miles away, and signals are going to be against us. There's a chap working. There's the Royal Mail depot. We're chasing an SPT livery 318. So this is going to be the theme up until we get to Motherwell. So it will do. Thank you. They're a tad weird, but there we are. We've got another Virgin Trains 390 about to pass us. Couple of squeaky bits coming from the Mark 3s. Okay, we're not too far away from Motherwell, so I think. We'll stick that back to waiting. Should allow enough distance between us and the train ahead. Run at half the line speed. Then we're due in a couple of seconds late. Not too much I can do about that. But I'm trying to adhere to the signals. And now we're doing early. Another SBT service in front of us. Interesting how the signal now goes green, so presumably we're going to be actually passing that ScotRail service at some stage. Or SPT, anyway. Okay, so here we are at Motherwell. Again, a station I've never filmed at before, but one that I really should look into filming at. Probably stand about it, really. Wait, seriously? No way. That can't be right. But anyway, yes, it's another station I've never filmed at before, so it'll be one to do on the list. Welcome to Motherwell. Thank you kindly. What a lovely greeting you've given us. Doesn't appear like there's too long of a stop here either, which is nice. It's not as long as Carstairs anyway. Well, mind you, nothing's as long as Carstairs. Just be curious to see what's going to happen in terms of the
signalling.
With that other train in front of us. So far, we've been early at both our stops, so hopefully we get the same when we get to Glasgow. We've got 12 miles to go before we get there, and we are due in early.
Wang.
I really am curious to see what's going to happen with these signals. Old disused railway bridge, or it could even be a road bridge. And there it is. Well, at least the passengers are going to get a little bit longer to have a kit. Not worry about setting their alarm just yet. Or gives them enough time to get themselves even more freshened up so they can spend a little bit longer in the shower.
Yep, that doesn't help. Well, all we can do is just sit back and watch. We've got something behind us. Well, wherever that was. Oh, it was there. Oh. Oh, okay, cool. That can't be what I was waiting for, surely to God. Well, it might be. Nah, alright. I shall wait. Mind you, if you look how early I am due in at Glasgow, I think this wait is going to be just a little while. At least you can hear the fans, they're going on overtime. And that bus just disappeared into the ether. We'll pretend like we didn't see that. What bus? Exactly. No bus there to be seen. What are you on about? I don't know. What are you on about? I'm kind of making things up as I go along. You don't say! God, that took a while. Oh, hold on, wait for it. Hey, there it goes. There's like a portal to another dimension on that bridge. We got anybody else waiting behind there? No. Stick it at 30. That gives us enough time to slow down if there is a dodgy signal in front of us, which I suspect there will be. Oh, we were waiting for that train. Oh, how devious. That's green. Okay. Well, we'll see how this one goes then. Where is this place anyway? This is on Eddingston. Let's just see how the signals favour us on the remainder of this journey then, shall we? We've got, what, 8 miles to go before we hit Glasgow Central. Limit coming up, which doesn't really affect me all that much. Oh, here come the signals again. RSBT's 318 about to pass us. And boing. That's a problem. Please slow down in enough time. Oh god. Jesus Christ. I came down then just a bit faster than I wanted to. Whew. Okay. Is there actually anybody in here, or is it just me? No, I think it's just me. Just got to be prepared to stop at the next signal. So, where's this then? Yeah, I can't read that. Bit too blurry. Okay. Well, put the limiter on 30. There's no sense in me trying to go up to 75. Not if I'm chasing the signals. See what the next signal's like, and then we'll go from there. Problem is, I don't know how many more stations are in between us and Glasgow. Well, let's find out what we can do then. Five, six, about to come down. Okay, 3 miles to go. Signal blocks are in close proximity, so let's just be ready. Mind you, we've got 30 coming up anyway, so start slowing down in your... I'm just going past Pommardy Depot. We've got plenty of 390s in there from the looks of things. And a 221 Super Voyager. Kind of sat idling. We've got more. Thank you. But on this side, we've got an EWS 90 in the form of 90028. That will be coming up to take the empty coaching stock back down to the depot once we've done with our passage, as Colonel Fairley would say. Someone's got a bonfire on the go. That's a... right by the Reliance side as well. That's a tad naughty. We've got a 380 coming up as well. I wonder what that other one was. I heard another loud, looks like a Valenta. Another SPT unit in front of us. And we're coming to Glasgow Platform 1. Could let the train coast and it might slow down enough. Saying might, I'm not too sure. I might have to have a little bit of influence, but we'll wait and see. No, I think influence will be needed. Oh, hello.
Let's hop out here. All the things you expect. Still got another first Great Western once. Okay, I love it. That's brilliant. Slowly working our way in. 15 mile an hour limit. Although it doesn't say down here, there is a 15 limit. Basically, once you hit the centerpiece of this bridge into Glasgow. But you can see there 15 mph on all lines, and then that should drop to 15. You've got another ScotRail 380. Eighteen leaving, 156 leaving, Pendolino up there. I like the real mixture of liveries we've got going on here. This is fantastic. At 390.015. Something's fired up and going. And here we are, whoops. Here we are at Glasgow Central. We've brought the remainder of our train in. It'll be sitting pretty there. The other 90 will come down at some stage and pick us up. There goes a pair of 156s. There goes the other one. There goes that one. We've got this 390 that will be disappearing at some point. There's another 318. It's just absolute madness. I think it's fantastic. Let's find out how close we were to the buffers. Not too far. Well done, driver. You made it. That's you done for now. Excellent. Well, that was a fantastic little run. That was player use emergency brakes once. Kind of had to. That was excellent. Very, very enjoyable. And it turns out that my worries about my loose consist were nothing to worry about at all. So that was that. That was absolutely fantastic. That was an amazing scenario. I thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyed doing that one. So, next time around, we're once again on the West Coast Mainline, as we're going to be taking, I think it's this one. Yep, it'll be a Virgin Trains liveried 90, hauling a failed intercity swallow liveried 90, with a late running service. So, that one does, again, start at Carlisle and go into Glasgow Central, so that's what we will be doing next. So, thank you all very much for watching. It is greatly appreciated. If you've enjoyed this today, then please do like and subscribe. Feel free to leave a comment. I do get back to them as and when I get the opportunity to. And until next time, I shall see you all later. Take care, guys. Goodbye.